हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टीचर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स टीचिंग ए लेवल सिंस 10 इयर्स। आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड सॉल्यूशन फॉर ऑल थ्री एशियन जोन्स 3-1, 3-2 एंड 3-3। नाउ आई वांट टू डिलीवर माय लेक्चर्स ऑनलाइन। इट्स वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू इफ़ यू वांट टू लर्न द पास्ट पेपर सॉल्यूशन ऑनलाइन। Now we should move towards question number 1. Use logarithms to solve the equation 4 power 3x minus 1 is equal to 35, giving your answer correct to 3 decimal places. It carry 4 marks. Taking ln on both sides, we take ln on both sides in order to solve the equation. When we take ln, we use power rule here. The power 4x minus 3 should be in the start and then ln of 4, and on the right side we use the product rule for logarithm. Product rule means the product of ln should be right in the form of sum. Ln of 3 into 5 power x is equal to ln of 3 plus ln of 5 power x. In this way, we will simplify this question and find the answer x is equal to 0.95975. Now, we'll move towards question number 2. Expand 1 over 1 minus 2 x under root in ascending power x up to and including the terms x cube. It means we should find the equations till x cube. Here we use binomial expansion. If you learn the formula for binomial expansion, then it's very easy to find the solution of this question. We applied formula only if the first constant is 1, positive 1, and other is variable, whatever else. We should apply the formula 1 plus nx, n mean power minus 1 by 2 and variable minus 2x. 1 plus nx plus n into n minus 1 into x square over 2 factorial plus n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into x cube over 3 factorial. In this way, we simplify this term, we will find the final answer 1 plus x plus 3x square over 2 plus 5x square over 2. Now, question 3 is related to the integration part. It's the most difficult part of the integration. Here we use by parts method to solve the integration. When you are using by parts method, you should remember that we applied the derivation and integration together. Here is x square is a variable and sine 2x is a function. When there is one variable and one function, you should remember, I strongly recommend you that you should apply integration on function always and derivate the variable. If you derivate the variable and integrate, if you integrate the variable, then it will not possible to solve the equation. So, when applied a by parts method, first we integrate sine 2x and write x square as it is. The integration of sine 2x is minus cos 2x, and the further integration of 2x is 1 by 2, because derivation of 2x is 2 and the integration is 1 by 2. Then take negative and integration symbol, write the integrated function as it is, minus cos 2x over 2, and derivative x square, which will become 2x dx. When we simplify this question, we should get minus x square cos 2x over 2 plus integration of x cos 2x dx. Here again we have one variable and one function. We integrate the cos 2x and derivative x. When we integrate cos 2x, it will become sine 2x over 2 and write x as it is, minus integration of sine 2x over 2, but the integrated function should be as it is, and the derivation of x is 1. अगेन वी यूज इंटीग्रेट माइनस एक्स स्क्वेयर ओवर टू इंटू कॉस टू एक्स प्लस एक्स ओवर टू इंटू साइन टू एक्स एज इट इज वैन वी इंटीग्रेट साइन टू एक्स इट विल बिकम माइनस कॉस टू एक्स ओवर टू एंड फाइनली इट विल बिकम माइनस कॉस टू एक्स ओवर फोर. After integrating this part, we should apply the limits, upper limit minus lower limit. The rule is that first you should apply limit upper, then take a negative sign and then apply the lower limit. Upper limit is pi by 2 and lower limit is 0. We place the value pi by 2 in the variable x. Minus 1 by 2 into pi by 2 whole square cos 2 into pi by 2 plus pi by 4. Sine 2 into pi by 2 minus cos 2 into pi by 2 over 4 minus. Then we should place value 0 in the place of variable x. In this way, when we simplify this question, we will get minus pi square over 8 because cos 2 over 2, it will become cos 2 of pi by 2 is cancelled with each other and cos of pi is minus 1, so minus minus plus 8, not minus pi by pi square over 8 into minus 1 plus sine. When we cancelled out the pi by 2 with 2, the value of sine pi is 0, so it will become 0. Cos 2 and 2 is cancelled with each other and cos pi is minus 1, so minus 1 by 4. Minus cos of 0 is 1 and we find minus 1 by 4. When we simplify this question, we will get the final answer pi square minus 4 over 8. Now question 4 is related to the derivation part and some rules of logarithm. The curve with equation y is equal to ln of x square over x has two stationary points. Find the exact values of the coordinates of these stationary points. It means we should find the both coordinates x and y, not omega x, by using quotient rule in derivation. Quotient rule means first we should derivate the numerator and write denominator as it is, minus write the numerator as it is and take the derivative of denominator over denominator whole square. In this question, dy over dx is equal to, first we derivate ln of x square, 2 into ln of x, then take the derivation ln of x, first we derivate power, then we derivate inside ln of x. The derivation of power will become 2 into ln of x and derivation ln of x is 1 over x and we write the denominator x as it is, minus write ln of x square as it is and take the derivation of denominator x is 1. At stationary point, dy over dx always 0 because it's a gradient, but when gradient the stationary point, at stationary point gradient will become 0. So we take 2 ln of x minus ln of x square is equal to 0. Ln of x, take common ln of x, so we get ln x into 2 minus ln of x is equal to 0, ln of x is equal to 2 and ln of x is equal to 0, so x is equal to e power 0. E power 0 means the base of ln is always e. When we change this ln of x into index form, we get x is equal to e power 0 because base of ln is e, so it will become x is equal to e power 0. E power 0 is equal to 1. In the same way, ln of x is equal to 2, the base of ln is 2. When we change into index form, so it will become x is equal to e power 2. Now we put this value in equation number 1. Equation number 1 means the equation which is written in the question form. Y is equal to ln of x whole square over x. We put the value of 1. We get the value of y is equal to 0 because ln of 1 is 0. So 0 over 1 is a 0. Similarly, we put the value of e, ln of e square whole square over e square, so 2 ln of e, because power should be in front of logarithm, it's a basic rule of logarithm. 2 ln of e whole square over e square, ln of e is 1, So it will become 4 over 2 square is 4, 4 over a square, so it will become 4 e power minus 2, and the first stationary point is 1 and 0, and second stationary point is e square and 4 e power minus 2. Question number 5 is related to the trigonometric part. In order to solve this question, you should have full grip on formula, I mean identities of trigonometry. If you have a good strength on trigonometric functions formula identities, then it will very easy for you, otherwise it will be difficult. We should write, we should take left hand side to solve it and get the answer which is required in right hand side. We take left hand side and prove it to the right hand side. We divide the cos 4 theta in the form cos 2 theta plus 2 theta minus the identity of cos 2 theta. 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta. But then the identity of cos a plus b, 2 theta plus 2 theta behaving like a cos a plus b, cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So cos 2 theta, cos 2 theta minus sin 2 theta, sin 2 theta minus 4. Now we reduce the cos square theta in the form of sin square theta by using identity. Cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, because we need only a solution in the form of sin theta. Cos is not included on the right hand side. Cos square theta first will become, we use identity cos 2 theta, so cos square theta minus sin square theta whole square, because there are two terms, cos 2 theta into cos 2 theta will become whole square, and then use the identity for sin 2 theta. Sin 2 theta is equal to 2 sin theta cos theta, so it will become 2 sin theta cos theta whole square, because sin 2 theta into sin theta. So minus 4 plus 8 sin square theta. Here we use again identity, cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, so it will become 1 minus sin square theta whole square theta, not 1 minus sin square, 1 minus 2 sin square. Here 1 minus sin square theta, not, it's a 1 minus 2 sin square theta whole square minus 4 cos square theta sin square theta minus this 1 minus sin square theta this. Hence we expand this equation, 1 minus 2 sin square theta whole square. Here only written up sin square theta, no, it's here is 2 sin square theta, because when we apply identity cos square theta minus sin square theta, write 1 minus sin square theta minus sin square theta, so it will become 1 minus 2 sin square theta. When we open the, when we expand the identity, 1 minus sin, 1 minus 2 sin square theta, and will become 1 plus 4 sin 4 theta minus 4 sin square theta minus 4 sin theta minus, and hence we get the final answer 8 sin 4 theta minus 3. Now we should move towards part 2 of this question. In order to find, solve this equation, cos 4 theta is equal to 4 cos theta plus 3 for angle range is from 0 to 360. So we write here cos 4 theta minus 4 cos 2 theta is equal to 3. We place the identity 8 sin 4 theta minus 3 is equal to 3. So taking square root on both sides, sin square theta will become under root 3 by 4. Again we take the square root on both sides, so sin theta is equal to under root 3 over 4 whole power 1 by 2. By using calculator, we find the final sin theta is equal to plus minus 0.9306. We take two positive values of sin theta and two negative values of sin theta, because the range of sin theta is from, theta is from 0 to 360. Sin is positive in first quadrant and positive in second quadrant, and negative in third and negative in fourth quadrant. When we take theta is equal to sine inverse of this, this is the basic angle, which is theta is equal to 68.6. and in second quadrant 180 minus 68.6 and in third quadrant 180 plus 68.4 not 4 6, and in fourth quadrant 360 minus 68.6 we get final answer 68.6, 1111.4, 248.6, 291.4. Here is the sum mistake. 68.4, not 68.4. Here is the value 68.6. So we get the final answer. We learn these formulas from these four quadrants. A are all positive, sign positive, tan positive, cos positive. If you learn the sentence add sugar to coffee, then you should easily learn the formula. Add method, add means all positive, sugar mean only sign positive, 2 mean only tan positive, coffee mean only cos positive, other negative. Now the question number 6 is related to the differential equation. It's the most difficult question in this paper. So first, which the variable x and theta satisfy the differential equation 3 plus cos 2 theta dy by d theta x sin 2 theta, and it is given that x is equal to 3 and theta is equal to this. Solve the differential equation and draw an expression for x in terms of theta. We find the x in terms of theta. It means x should be the subject and theta on the right side. You should remember that I also strongly recommended that when you are solving the differential equation, you take the variable of y on left side and the variable theta on right side. Here is x dx over d theta. Dy over dx, no, it's a dx over d, dx over x, not a dy. Dx over x, by mistake it is written as dy over dx, no, it's a dx over x is equal to sine 2 theta over 3 plus cos 2 theta into d theta. First of all, I separated the variable x and theta on left and right side, then applied integration. The integration of 1 over x is ln of x, because derivation of ln of x is 1 over x. That integration is inverse of derivation. So integration of 1 over x is ln of x. Here we applied the rule, same rule here. Because 3 plus cos 2 theta, the derivation of 3 plus cos 2 theta is minus 2 sine 2 theta. We multiplied by minus 2 and also divided by minus 2 in order to take the integration of this right hand portion. Okay, from here you see that 3 plus cos 2 theta, the derivation of 3 plus cos 2 theta, derivation of 3 is 0, the derivation of cos 2 theta is minus 2 sine 2 theta, hence we applied the rule of ln. So ln of x is equal to minus 1 by 2 ln of 3 plus cos 2 theta plus c. In order to find the value of c, we applied the value x is equal to 3 and theta is equal to pi by 4. In this way, we get the final value of c is equal to ln of 3 plus ln of under root 3. Here we applied the logarithmic rule. We should write the ln in some form and change it into product form. So ln 3 multiplied by under root 3, hence it will become c is equal to ln of under root 27. Now applied the value of c in the previous equation, ln of x is equal to minus 1 over 2 ln of 3 plus cos 2 theta plus ln of 27, ln of 27. Ln of x will become ln of 27 over under root 3 plus cos 2 theta. We take this value minus 1 over 2 ln of 3 plus cos 2 theta on the left hand sides. So not a left hand side, we applied the formula for negative function in logarithmic form. So ln of 27 in minus form the function should be divided. So ln of under root 27 over under root 3 plus cos theta under root due to power minus 1 by 2. So x is equal to under root 27 over under root 3 plus cos 2 theta whole power 1 by 2. Ln is cancelled out by ln and this will become this. Here the under root 27 and under root 3 plus cos 2 theta will shifted to upper part. So not need to write under root 27 and under root this, only take power 1 by 2. In part 2, question number said the least value taken by x. Least value of x possible when theta is equal to 0. It means the smallest value of x. So we put the theta is equal to 0 and get the value of x is 2.59. Now we will move towards the part partial fraction. Here is a one type of partial fraction. There are I think three or four parts of partial fraction or methods to solve the partial fraction. Here is 4x square plus 7x plus 4 over 2x plus 1 into x plus 2. If we multiply the denominator, then we will get the highest power x square. If the powers of variables in numerator and denominator is equal, or the power of variable in denominator is less than the power of less than the power of numerator, we should divide first and change into quotient and remainder form. When we divide 4x square plus 7x plus 4 by 2x square plus 5x plus 2, we multiply 2x plus 1 by x plus 2 and get the denominator 2x square plus 5x plus 2. So when we divide the numerator by denominator, we get that 2 is quotient, minus 3x is remainder, and 2x square plus 5x plus 2 is the divider. Again, we take the form 2x plus 1 into x plus 2, 2 plus minus 3x over 2x plus 1 into x plus 2. Hence, we partial this equation minus 3x over 2x plus 1 into x plus 2 because the power of denominator variable is greater than the power of numerator. So, is equal to a over 2x plus 1 plus b over x plus 2. It's a linear function. It should be easy to solve. We multiply 2x plus 1 and x plus 2 on both sides. We get minus 3x is equal to a into x plus 2 plus b into 2x plus 1. We take any value of variable x to solve in order to find the value of a and b. But easy to put x plus 2 is equal to 0. Get x is equal to minus 2. In this way, a will become 0 and find the value of b easy. So when we put the x is equal to minus 2, get the value of b is minus 2. Again, we will put the value of x is equal to 0 and value of b equal to minus 2 in the previous equation. We find that a into 0 plus 2 minus 2 into 0 plus 1 is equal to a is equal to 2, and in this way we can find the value of a is equal to 1. Hence, the final partial fraction will become 2 plus 1 over 2x plus 1 minus 2 over x plus 2, putting the value of a and b, and the take the quotient also, because quotient is also part of a partial fraction. Now, move toward the question number 7, part 2. It's an integration. The integration of limits 4, 0, fx, dx, we should prove it to 8 minus 7 over 3. We place the partial value in this function f of x because it is equal to the other value. 2 plus 1 over 2x plus 1 minus 2 over x plus 2. The integration of 2 is 2x because integration of constant is variable, and the integration and the derivation of variable is constant, because when we take the derivation of 2x, it will become 2, and the integration of 2 is 2x. Again, we applied the rule, because the derivation of ln of x is 1 over x, and the integration of 1 over x will become ln of x. Here, the derivation of 2x plus 1 is 2, वी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टू एंड डिवाइडेड बाय टू इन ऑर्डर टू चेंज इट इनटू लॉगरिथमिक फॉर्म. सो वन ओवर टू राइट एज इट इज एंड द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ टू ओवर टू एक्स प्लस वन इज एल एन ऑफ टू एक्स प्लस वन एंड सिंपली वी शुड राइट टू एज इट इज एंड द इंटीग्रेशन वन ओवर एक्स प्लस टू इज एल एन ऑफ एक्स प्लस टू बिकॉज डेरिवेशन ऑफ एक्स प्लस टू इज वन. As we applied the upper limit 4 and lower limit 0 here, first we put the value of 4 in place of x and then put a negative sign and then put the value of lower limit 0 in place of x, we get the final answer. We get 8 plus ln of 9 under root minus ln of 6 square minus the value 2 will become power of the logarithm and 1 by 2 also become the power of in logarithmic function, then minus plus ln of 2 and 2 is also in the power because 2 is in front of ln and it will become the power. In this way 8 plus ln of 3, because in logarithmic function the function which are added they will be changed into multiplication form and the function which is in subtracting form will divide in logarithmic function. So 8 plus ln of 3, 8 plus ln of 3 power minus 1. In this way we should place a power in front of logarithm. So 8 minus ln of 3 is the final. Now move towards question number 8. Diagram shows the curve. I didn't draw diagram because question is available in every format only. Focus on your solution. The diagram shows the curve y is equal to cosecant x for limit x is greater than 0 but less than pi, and a part of the curve y is equal to e power minus x where x is equal. It means there are two curves. One curve is equal to cosecant x and the other curve y is equal to in the form of function e power minus x. The tangent to the curves are parallel. It means if the tangents are parallel, then the derivative of these two curves should be equal. It means the gradient of these two curves should be equal when x is equal to a. First we derivate y is equal to cosecant x, then we derivate y is equal to e power minus x. So derivation of first y is equal to cosecant x. In first part, differentiate y is equal to cosecant x, find derivation of this cosecant x cot x. Y is equal to cosecant x, we use identity. Y is equal to 1 over sin x. Here we applied the quotient rule. Quotient rule means dy over dx, the derivation of the numerator, it means derivation of 1 is 0, and write the sin x as it is. Then put a negative sign and write the numerator 1 as it is and take the derivation of denominator sin x is cos x over square of the denominator which will become sin square x. So sin x into 0 will become 0. So minus cos x over, we separate the sin square x in the form minus sin minus cos x over sin x into 1 over sin x which. So minus cos x over sin x will become minus cot x and 1 over sin x will become cosecant x. We use trigonometric identities here. Again, by equating the gradients of the curves x is equal to a, show that a is equal to tan inverse e power a over sin a. We derivate both equations and compare the derivation of these two both equations. Y is equal to e power minus x and dy over dx is equal to e power minus x, derivation is e power minus x and the derivation of minus x is minus 1, so it will become minus e power minus x. Again, we have already derivative y is equal to cosecant x will become minus cosecant x cot x. So we compare the derivation. We compare the derivation and change the form cosecant x cot x into 1 over sin x into 1 over tan x. Okay, we use trigonometric identities because dy over dx is equal to minus cosecant x cot x. We change the cosecant x into 1 over sin x and cot x into 1 over tan x and apply the value x is equal to a here. we take that 1 over sine a, 1 over tan a is equal to minus e power minus a. So 1 over sine a is equal to e power minus a tan a. So 1 over e power minus a sine a is equal to tan a. We take the value e of power minus a in the denominator in order to take the value. So a finally a is equal to tan inverse of the e power a over sine of a, which is a required form in the part 2. So then move towards the second part. Verify by calculation that a lies between 1 and 1.5. It's very easy part. We should write the equation a is equal to tan inverse e power a over sine a. Here is a tan inverse, then it will become tan a on the left hand side. Then multiplied sine a because it is denominator, and take the value e power minus e power a on the left hand side, it becomes a. First we put a value of a in this equation, so it is minus 1.4, which is less than 0. And then putting the value 1.5, we get 9.58, which is greater than 0. It means the roots lies because the function is changed from positive to negative. So it means the root is lies between 1 and 1.5. Now in part 4, use iterative formula based on the equation in part 2 to determine a correct 3 decimal places, giving the result to each iteration 5. It means we take each iteration the values to till 5 decimal places. If you take the value till 4 decimal places, then answer is not correct. First of all, we take A1. We find in part 3 that the solution is your root is lies between 1 and 1.5. We estimate that the value, middle value, 1 plus 1.5 over 2. And here we get the value a1 is equal to 1.25. Then get the value of a2 by putting the value of a1 in place of a. So e power 1.25 and sine 1.25, then take the tan inverse, it will become 1.30533. In this way we will get the values. Then we put the value of a2 in order to find the value of a3. In similar way, you should iterate till the 2 decimal place, because he required that the answer should be 3 decimal places. When 3 decimal places repeated, then that is the final answer. So first iteration is 1.314, second is 1.316, third is 1.316. So these two values are repeated. Hence the solution is 1.317, because when we round off 9, so we increase the value by 1.317. Now question 4 is related to the vector equations. Vector is the difficult part, because there are lines equations and planes equations. Here the point A, B and C have position vectors related to the origin are this and this. The fourth point D is such that the equation, the quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. In this question, he says that the ABCD is a coordinate, is a parallelogram. ABC quadrilateral is a parallelogram. In parallelogram, the opposite sides are equal and parallel to each other. So AB is equal to DC, because the opposite sides are equal in parallelogram. So AB is equal to OB minus OA, and DC is equal to OC minus OB. We take the coordinates of point D is X, Y, Z. In this way, X, Y, Z is equal to 2, 1, 2, 5, minus 1, and 1 plus 1, 2, 3, minus 0, 4, 1. So the coordinates of OD is 3, 3 and 1, it's a simple one. So OD is equal to 3i plus 3j plus k. It shows that ABCD is a rhombus, then to show that ABC rhombus. Now we have to prove that ABCD parallelogram is a rhombus. Rhombus is a tilted form of squares. The all sides of rhombus are equal. If the opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal, then it means the four sides are equal. So AB is equal to OB minus OA and BC is equal to OC minus OB. So AB will become minus 1, 2 and minus 2 and BC will become 2, 2 and minus 2. We will take the magnitudes on both sides. In order to take the magnitude, first we will take the magnitude of AB. Magnitude of AB is minus 1 square will become 1 and 2 square will become 4 and minus 2 square will become 4. And second, 2 square will become 4 and 2 square will become 4. Here is 5 minus 4 is 1. It is written by mistake here 2. Not a 2, here is 1. So 1, 5 minus 4 will become 1. By mistake it is right 2. So 2 square will become 4 and 1 square will become 1 and minus 2 square will become. So the magnitudes of AB is equal to magnitude of BC. It shows that ABCD is rhombus because we prove that ABCD is a parallelogram. So opposite sides are equal. In this way, four sides are equal. So equal to magnitude 3. It is a in part 2, the plane P is parallel to A. It means the plane P is parallel to A and the line BC lies in P. It means the line BC lies in the plane P and plane is parallel to and plane P is parallel to OA. Find the equation of P. Giving your answer in the form AX plus BY plus CZ is equal to D. So BC, first we should find the equation of BC, line BC. BC is equal to OC minus OB. It's a direction of BC. So direction of BC is 2, 1 and minus 2. To find the direction of plane, as plane is parallel to OA and BC lies in the plane. As the line BC lies in the plane and direction OA also lies in the plane, parallel mean lies in the plane. So the direction of plane will become the product of these two, the direction of these two lines, OA cross OB. First we take IJK. In this question I use the matrices method to find the direction of plane. IJK, the direction of OA is 1, 2, 3 and direction of BC is 2, 1, minus 2. First I find the I coordinates. I into, we hide the column I to I 1 and 2 and row IJK. Then take the matrix 2, 3, 1, minus 2. I find that it is minus 7. Again take negative sign J. Hide the column J, 2 and 1 and hide the row IJK. We take the matrix 1, 2 and 3, minus 2. We find the value minus 8. In the last plus K, hide the column K, 3, minus 2 and row IJK. We take the matrix 1, 2, 2, 1 and find the value minus 3. So direction of plane P is minus 7i plus 8j minus 3k. Equation of plane, the formula equation of plane is r dot n is equal to a dot n. Here n is the direction of the plane, which we get minus 7i plus 8j plus minus 3k. So r is x, y, z dot minus 7, 8 and minus 3 is equal to, we'll take any point A, B, C. 0, 4, 1 dot n minus 7, 8, minus 3 minus 7x plus 8y minus 3z is equal to minus 7 into 0 will become 0 plus 8, 4 times 32 minus 3, 1 times 3. So 32 minus 3 will become 29 and final equation minus 7x plus 8y minus 3z is equal to 29. Now we should move towards the question number 10. Showing all necessary working, solve the equation iota z square plus 2z minus 3 iota is equal to 0. Giving your answer in the form of complex number x plus iota y, where x and y are real and exact. You are familiar with the quadratic formula. Here we use the quadratic formula z is equal to minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac. To solve this equation, z will become minus 2 plus minus 4 plus 12 iota square. Iota square is equal to minus 1. We put the value of minus 1. So it will become minus 2 plus minus minus under root 8. Here not a under root 8, it's a minus under root 8 over 2 iota. It will become minus 2 plus minus 2 under root minus 2 over 2 iota. When we want to change the minus under root 2 into complex form, we place the value iota. So z is equal to minus 2 plus minus under root 4 plus 2. Here is not 2 iota square. It's a just for a minute. So minus 2 plus 2 under root minus iota. In order to reduce the iota from denominator, we multiplied by iota and also divide by iota. So in denominator it will become iota square. Iota square is equal to minus 1. We take common of 2 and it will cancel with the denominator 2. Z is equal to I plus minus under root 2. So it will become under 2 plus iota minus under 2 plus iota. In part B, on the sketch of Argand diagram shows the locus representing the complex number satisfying the equation Z modulus is equal to Z modulus minus 4 minus 3 iota. When there is a modulus on both sides, it means we should draw a perpendicular bisector of these two equations Z and Z minus 4 minus 3 iota. Draw perpendicular bisector of Z. Here is missing the real and imaginary part. It means the line starts from the point is 0, 0. Draw perpendicular to point 0, 0 and 4, 3. 0, 0 and 4, 3. Always you should draw the perpendicular bisector if there are modulus on both sides of the equation. We draw the perpendicular bisector of point 4, 3 and 0, 0. It will be like the line. Find the complex number is represented by the point on the locus where Z modulus is least. Find the modulus and argument of this complex number giving your answer kept to two decimal places. So Z is equal to Z plus 1 plus 5 iota. Z modulus is equal to 2 square plus 1 plus 5. Square, so Z modulus will become 2.5. Argument Z is equal to 10 inverse 1.5 over 2. Argument is 26.9 degree. When we want to take the modulus of Z for least value, we take the modulus from origin to the we take distance from origin which cut perpendicularly to the locus line. Okay, so perpendicular distance is here the x-axis will become 2 and y-axis cuts the line, y-axis at 1.5. It cuts the distance from origin to the locus line is the x-coordinate is 2 but the y-coordinate is 1.2. In this way we take the argument of z and also modulus of d. Modulus of z is 2.5 and argument of z is 36.9 degrees.